Welcome to my allotment, plot 3, North Warwickshire. Just want to have a look at a few of the things that I recycle, find. Got another couple of finds this week. But there are me kitchen rolls and my toilet rolls that I use now regularly. And the mushroom boxes, I found them very useful as well. And a neighbouring plot holder can get hold of the these tubs. And I've got my little plastic trays there for the you get grapes in, and yoghurt pots, ready for when we get the fruit. The fruit bottles, I'll use those in my potatoes, and you can actually stack those up so that you don't actually damp the leaves down, and alongside the cucumbers, pumpkins and other plants that tend to rot off. I'll go and show you my two finds from this week. Found those two 20 litre drums in a skip on Friday. That'll be ideal for putting my nettle tea in that's stewing in that barrel. And this, what I believe to be some greenhouse staging. The nuts and bolts look very similar. I've actually put some polycarbonate in from off my shed roof, cut it to size and fitted it. I thought that would make that'd be ideal for me washing station. That's two things I found, and there's just one more. I'll take you around the back of my shed. And wasn't sure exactly what it was, but it looks like it's one of those mortar tubs, but it's actually got a tap on. It was one of the units next to where I work, and I thought it would probably make an excellent wormery. Jim from Jim's allotment has just covered the wormery, but it's just finding a nice sheltered spot, because the worms will die if they get in the full sun. So I'm hoping it's large enough. It's 300 litres. It might be too big. It might not suit this location. But we will see. Right. We'll get off and do some weeding. Today's video is the day before I'd normally take you a tour around the plot. So, this is finished boarding this set now. Roof's on, as we know. I've now got all my tools stacked up. Some I've repaired. That hoe there, that was 50 pence. Well worn. Somebody's loved that hoe, and I love it now. It's ideal for chopping those weeds off. This garden fork, I'll put a new handle on it. That was also 50 pence at the local tip recycling centre. This spade, again 50 pence. I've actually welded a bar on it, and some more metal at the top there. That'll never break. There's my dibber, an old shovel or fork, ideal. And that's my weeding tool of choice. Really get on well with that. That's what I'm going to use tonight. And there's my rake that I've had at home for years. Let's go and do some weeding around the onions. Just before we go. That's my enormous rake. I think it's what they may use on golf courses for the sand. That levels the ground out brilliantly, especially with the soil I've got. We'll move on. The ideal time to do the weeding is when the soil's nice and dry, and any weeds that you drag out, they'll just rot off. This is a really useful tool. Any weeds that are close to the plants, just put it on its side, just pull it out. It's just so you don't damage the plants and I don't have to actually get on the beds. Tony's allotment, he covered this as well. He used hoe, but this is a tool I like to use. Gets into all the nooks and crannies without damaging the roots. Anyway, I'll carry on. So I've weeded all around that now. Hopefully now they'll just die off. There's no rush to get every weed. Any that come up next week I'll remove when they're a little bit bigger. So my onions now seem to be doing really well. I've been very lucky. I haven't actually seen any seed heads on mine, where I know a lot of other people are having problems. So this is what I get up to before I shoot my main video. Have a nice hoe round. Make it look presentable. Doesn't take long as you do it regularly. And that tool that I use just breaks the surface up. Sort of just irritates the weeds out the ground, and hopefully then the soil dries out and they don't grow back. Anyway, we'll speak again soon, and happy growing.